Did you know that burning a gallon of gas creates 19 pounds of carbon dioxide? And that's bad, because carbon dioxide is what's heating up our planet. And that's really bad. So if you think about it, carbon dioxide is actually worse than poop. Carbon dioxide is also called CO2. And a bit of CO2 is okay. The plants need to breathe, kind of like poop. I mean, poop can turn into dirt if you just have a little bit. If you have a lot, well, that's a problem. And we've been making way too much carbon dioxide because we keep driving cars. We keep using energy from dirty fuels we dig out of the ground, like coal, and we keep driving cars that burn gas, and they make a lot of CO2. CO2 is an invisible gas that exists in nature. We breathe in oxygen, and when we breathe out, we create CO2. The plants in the soil and in the oceans take that CO2 and give us back oxygen. That's part of what's called the carbon cycle. And the amount of carbon in the cycle needs to stay the same. But when we pump extra carbon out of the ground and burn it, well, that throws the whole system out of balance. Remember how I said that every gallon of gas we burn turns into 19 pounds of carbon dioxide? How is that even possible? Well, when your car burns gas, the gas combines with the oxygen in the air. The carbon only weighs a little bit, but the oxygen actually weighs a lot. So when they combine, that makes a carbon dioxide molecule, which is a whole lot heavier. But CO2 is a gas, not a solid.
Where did you go?
That's why you can't see it, and it takes up a lot more room than a solid. So that's why it floats up and becomes part of the Earth's atmosphere, part of the air that keeps us all alive. And now, all that extra CO2 is trapping heat from the sun and heating up our planet. It's making the weather act weird, and that hurts the plants and animals, and people too. But it's hard to remember that carbon dioxide pollution is the problem. You can't see it, smell it, or taste it. And it's just this invisible thing floating up in the air. What if that 19 pounds of carbon dioxide gas was 19 pounds of poop instead? A minivan. You know, like the one your parents drive you to school in? A minivan would make a pound of poop every mile. If you live 3 miles from school, that's 12 pounds of poop every day. Or maybe your parents drive a pickup truck or a luxury sedan, like a Lexus or a Buick or a BMW. Or maybe someone drives you around in a big SUV, like a Yukon or a Suburban or a Mercedes. Wow, that's a lot of poop. Some economy cars and some hybrids, like the Prius, don't make as much CO2. And anyway, you might think that 1 pound per mile isn't that much. But it really adds up. Now, if all that CO2 was poop, it would be bad, right? Well, it is bad. Worse than poop, in fact. We have to stop putting all this carbon dioxide into the air before the planet gets too much hotter. But luckily, we don't have to live like this anymore.
Who will save us?
How cool. It's the Green Ninja, the climate action superhero. Thanks, Green Ninja. There are lots of clean ways for us to get around now. Electric cars and trolleys are a lot cleaner, no matter where they get their power from. But especially if they get their energy from the sun or the wind or other renewable forms of energy and not a poop and coal plant. And you know, Some people say it's too expensive to stop driving gas cars, but actually, most people spend a lot of money on gas. And fossil fuels are in limited supply, so gas keeps getting more and more expensive. Leasing a brand new electric car is pretty cheap, and clean energy is also getting cheaper and cheaper. Riding the bus or the train is also a lot cheaper and way more fun. So is riding your bike or your skateboard or your scooter. And walking is free. So tell your parents it's time to stop driving gas-burning cars. I mean, yuck.
Hey, Elliot, can you please go plug in the car?
Sure. Can I go ride my skateboard?
Sure. But after you plug in the car. And also, you need to do your homework.
Oopsies, forgot.